My name is Heather Wheeler, and I have a PhD in genetics, and I work in Eileen Dolan's lab. So I came as a postdoc about 5 years ago, and now I work as a research professional, and I do computational biology research. So as a member of the Dolan lab, we're interested in understanding how people respond differently to chemotherapeutic drugs that are used to treat cancer. And one project I'm working on is looking at genetic variation among a cohort of individuals who have had testicular cancer, and one of the drugs that they get treated with causes some really debilitating side effects. So they can lose their hearing, and they can also have neuropathy, so loss of feeling in their extremities, and we'd like to understand why some people get this symptom and some don't. By looking at differences among the DNA of individuals, we can try to tease that apart. So I grew up in rural Minnesota, so growing up in a small town is great because you get to participate in tons of activities. So in school I did sports, I did music, I did math league, I did all of that. And then as I grew up and became a teenager, I actually got interested in forensic science, mainly because I loved reading crime novels. That led me to look for colleges to go to that had forensic science programs. So I ended up at Hamline University, which is in St. Paul. So I majored in biology and also did their forensic program. And I actually worked in the state crime lab for 2 years doing DNA analysis. And as I was doing this, I realized, although it's really cool to use DNA as a fingerprint to identify people, I was more interested in how these differences in the DNA that we were measuring led to differences among individuals. So why certain people get diseases and others don't. And that led me here to Eileen's lab to study pharmacogenomics. So again, continuing on, why do these DNA differences lead to differences among individuals? So in my day-to-day, I do a lot of scripting using programming languages like Python or R, which is a statistical programming language. And a lot of that is data wrangling, getting data in the right format, but it's sort of like solving a puzzle, and I always liked puzzles, so.
So the software measures the length of all these guys. Right.
One aspect of my job that I really like doing is I'm the first person that gets to synthesize the data. So we have clinical data coming in from medical doctors who see patients and collect the data. And then we have the genetic data coming in from sequencing centers. So we measure the variation among individuals. And I'm the person that gets to put that together. So to see if we can find associations between those two things. So it's very exciting to be the one to push the button and make a potentially new discovery, and to think about how we want to present any results we find in terms of making plots and then follow-up studies from that. So to all you kids out there who are interested in biology or maybe even slightly interested, I would encourage you to take as many math classes as you can, to learn how to program, go online, download bioinformatics tutorials, because I think that's where the future of biology lies. And even if you're interested in going in the lab and pipetting, that's great too, but still focus on the math, because cancer isn't easy and we need as many tools as possible to understand and to move forward with better treatments.